Dear students, in this video we shall discuss about the some of the propositions related to maximal ideals. So proposition number 3, an ideal M in a ring Z is a maximal ideal if and only if M is equal to P into Z, where P is a prime. Observe that an ideal M in a ring Z is a maximal ideal if and only if M is of the form M is equal to PZ, where P is a prime. So here first we shall prove the converse part. So here we shall assume, suppose M is equal to P into Z, where P is a prime. Here we shall assume that M is equal to PZ, where P is a prime. What we have to prove? We have to show that this M is a maximal ideal of Z. So for that, now first we shall consider, let I be any ideal of Z. So we shall consider now, let I be any ideal of Z, and that ideal is containing M. We shall consider one ideal that containing M. So then we can write, I can be written as M into Z. Observe that M is equal to P into Z, where P is a prime, we shall assume. To prove M is a maximal ideal, I will consider one more ideal I that is containing M. So then I is of the form M into Z, we can write. Now again observe that, since I is containing M and M is of the form P into Z, this element P is belongs to M and M is properly contained in I. So that implies P belongs to I. P is an element of M and that M is properly contained in I. So that implies P is an element of I. Now I is of the form M into Z, so we can denote P as, then P can be written as P is equal to M into some K, that K is belongs to set of all integers Z, we can say that. So observe that P is equal to M into K, where K belongs set of all integers Z. So what it implies now? This implies M divides P. Observe that P can be written as M into K. Now this M divides P, so we can write M divides P. And what about, we know that about the P, P is a prime. So then M has to be either equal to 1 or M is equal to P. P is a prime and M divides P, so that implies either M is equal to 1 or M is equal to P. So when M is equal to 1, I can be written as, then I is equal to 1 into Z, so that is equal to Z, that Z is equal to now set up all integers, so that we are taken as a ring now, R. Or when M is equal to P, I can be written as P into Z, so that is P into Z is capital letter M, so that is maximal ideal. So therefore M is a maximal ideal. Observe that we shall consider one ideal I that is properly containing M. Our intention is to prove M is a maximal ideal. So observe that as M is properly contained in I and an element P belongs to M, so that implies P is also an element of I. So now I is of the form M into Z, so we can write P as M into K, for some K belongs to Z now. So as M equal to, as P equal to M into K, that implies M divides P, and also we know that P is a prime. So by using that we can say that either M is equal to 1 or M is equal to P. So then I is equal to, as M equal to 1, I is equal to 1 into Z, so that is Z, so that is equal to ring R. Or when M is equal to P, I is equal to P into Z, so that is equal to M. So therefore M is a maximal ideal. So that proves the converse part. Let us prove the direct part. Here we shall assume that, let I be a maximal ideal of Z. Here we shall assume let I be a maximal ideal of Z, where I can be written as M into Z. Let I be a maximal ideal of Z and I is equal to M into Z. We shall take our intention is to prove this M is a prime. Observe that let I be a maximal ideal we shall consider, and we shall denote that I is equal to M into Z. Our intention is to prove this M is a prime. Suppose this M is not a prime. So at that time we can say that this M has a proper divisor. Suppose M is not a prime, so then M has a proper divisor. So that proper divisor I will consider K. M has a proper divisor K. So at that time M can be written as M is equal to some L into K, where K is a proper divisor of M. So here L is varies between 1 and M. Similarly, K is also strictly greater than 1, it's necessary, and strictly less than M. So M is equal to L into K, where K is a proper divisor of M, and that K is greater than 1, strictly greater than 1, and strictly less than M. So now we have to prove M is a prime. Suppose this M is not a prime, so that has a proper divisor. So now we shall consider one ideal. Suppose J is one more ideal, so that is equal to K into Z. I will consider one more ideal J, that is equal to K into Z I will consider. Now we know that K is a proper divisor of M. We can say that M is belongs to J. Observe that K is a proper divisor of M. So by using that we can say that this element M is belongs to the ideal J, and hence already M is an element of I. Now that element M is belongs to the ideal J. So therefore I is properly contained in J. So this inclusion is proper because an element K is belongs to J, but K does not belongs to I. Observe that K belongs to J because J can be written as K into Z. If Z is 1 and one element 1 belongs to Z, we can say that K belongs to J, we can say that. But that K does not belongs to I. So therefore I is properly contained in J. So now as K is a proper divisor of M, we can say that K belongs to J and K does not belongs to I. And also observe that now this ideal what we took J, that is not equal to R. That R is here Z. Observe that I took J as K into Z here. That J is now different from R because we took K as strictly greater than 1. So now J is not equal to R, and again observe that J is a proper ideal that properly containing I. So that is a contradiction to the maximality of I. So therefore this M is a prime. Observe that J is not equal to R, and this is an ideal J, is a proper ideal J containing proper ideal I. So that is a contradiction to the maximality of ideal I. So therefore M is prime. Therefore M is a prime. So that proves the proposition number 3. An ideal M in Z is a maximal ideal if and only if M is equal to P into Z, where P is a prime. So let us move to the proposition number 4. Here statement of the proposition is, let R be a commutative ring with unit, and ideal M is a maximal ideal if and only if R by M is a field. Observe that here let R be a commutative ring with unit element, and ideal M is a maximal ideal if and only if R by M is a field we have to prove. To prove this proposition, we have to consider again four more propositions. Here, first proposition I will consider that is already proved in the previous classes, that is also in the previous unit, rings. So, proposition number one is, any field is a simple ring. Observe that proposition number one here, any field is a simple ring. That means that ring has only two ideals, no improper ideals, zero, and that ring R itself, that has no proper ideals. Proposition number two is, let R be a commutative ring with a unit which is a simple ring, then R is a field. Observe that let R be a commutative ring with the unit element, and that is, and that ring is a simple ring, then that is a field. So observe that any field is a simple ring, but that simple ring cannot be a field always. That ring has to be a commutative ring with unit element and also a simple ring, then we can say that that ring is a field. So that about the proposition number 1 and 2. Now proposition number 3, let I be an ideal in a ring R and P is a mapping from R to R by I, that mapping is called as the projection mapping, then any ideal J containing I is an ideal in R if and only if projection mapping P of J is equal to J by I is an ideal of R by I. Observe that I is an ideal in a ring R, and we shall consider one projection map P from R to R by I, then any ideal J containing the an ideal in R, if and only if P of J is equal to J by I here, that is an ideal of R by I. Here this proposition also we shall prove in proving the previous proposition. So next proposition number 4 here, let R be a commutative ring with a unit element whose ideals are 0 and R itself, so that has no proper ideals, then that ring is a field we can see. So let us prove this proposition. Here first I will consider, let R be a commutative ring with unit. I will consider here, let R be a commutative ring with unit. As R is a commutative ring, I can say that R by M is also a commutative ring with unit. Let R be a commutative ring. So by using that, we can say that R by M is also a commutative ring with the unit element 1. So what we have to prove now? R by M is a field we have to prove. So I observe that by using the proposition 1 and 2 here, R by M is a field. Observe that here, R by M is a field if and only if it has no proper ideal. It has no proper ideal. Observe that here, proposition number 1 is any field is a simple ring, and proposition number 2 is let R be a commutative ring with a unit element which is a simple ring, then R is a field. Now here R by M is a field I have to say. So that is if and only if it has no proper ideal. So by using the proposition number 1 and 2 I can say that. So now I will assume here corners part. Suppose R by M is a field. R by M is a field I will assume. What I have to prove? That is a M is a maximal ideal I have to prove. R by M is a field here, I have to prove M is a maximal ideal. To prove M is a maximal ideal, I have to consider one more ideal J that properly contains this ideal M. So for that now, let M is properly contained in J. So here J be any ideal. So then by using the proposition number 3 previous here, I can say that J by M is an ideal of R by M. Observe that proposition number 3 tells that if I is an ideal in a ring R and a mapping P from R to R by I, then an ideal J properly contains I implies J by I is an ideal of R by I. Here observe that M is ideal that properly contains an ideal J. So by using the proposition number 3, we can clearly say that J by M is an ideal of R by M. So now what we know that R by M is a field. So that field implies that that has no proper ideals. Only ideals are either 0 or R by M itself. So J by M is equal to either 0 or J by M is equal to R by M. So that implies now as J by M is equal to 0 implies J is equal to M. And J by M is equal to R by M implies J is equal to R. Observe that J is equal to M or J is equal to R. So what it implies? M is a maximal ideal. M is a maximal ideal. So observe that here. First I will consider here, let R be a commutative ring with the unit element. So by using that we can say that R by M is also a commutative ring with the unit element. So now again by using the previous proposition 1 to 4, I can say that R by M is a field if and only if it has no proper ideals. Only ideals are 0 and that ring R by M itself. So now our intention to prove M is a maximal ideal. To prove that one, I will assume R by M is a field. So I will assume first R by M is a field and I have to prove M is a maximal ideal. To prove M is a maximal ideal, I have to consider one more ideal. So I will consider one more ideal J. That ideal properly contains the ideal M. Now by using the proportion 3, we can say that J by M is an ideal of R by M. So that implies now as J by M is a field, R by M is a field, it has only ideal 0 and R by M. So when J by M equal to 0, we will obtain J as M. When J by M is equal to R by M, we will obtain J is equal to R. So therefore, there is no proper ideal properly containing M. So that implies M is a maximal ideal. So that proves the corners part. Now let us prove the direct part. Here we shall assume that M is a maximal ideal. Now again and also I will assume that J bar is equal to J by M be any ideal of R by M. Observe that here first I will assume M is a maximal ideal of R and again I will consider J bar is equal to J by M, that is an ideal of R by M. I have to prove R by M is a field. So now as J by M is an ideal of R by M, by using the previous proposition number 3, we can say that J is an ideal of R. J is an ideal of R and that J is properly containing M. Since M is a maximal ideal, this J has to be is equal to either R or J is equal to M. So what it implies? When J is equal to R, we will obtain J by M is equal to R by M, or when J is equal to M, we will obtain J by M is equal to 0. So only ideals of R by M are either 0 or R by M itself. So that means this R by M has no proper ideals. So that implies by using the proposition number 4, we can say that R by M is a field. We took first M is a maximal ideal and one more ideal J by M is an ideal of R by M. As J is an, by using the proposition number 3, we can say that now J is an ideal of R that properly containing M. Now again, this M is a maximal ideal. So by using that, we can say that J is equal to either R or J is equal to M. So that implies J by M equal to R by M or J by M is equal to 0. So only ideals of R by M are either 0 or R by M. So that means it has no proper ideals. So that implies R by M is a field by using the proposition number 4.